We are going to use this pillowcase to make part of a dress today, but not just any dress. We are starting our Harry Potter house-inspired dresses with our kings and queens of ambition, the Slytherins. Now, like our elegant house, we are doing a monochromatic corset dress with flat felled seams, exposed boning, and a cupped bodice. I'm also including this gorgeous silver chain, but not without our corgi break. And because we're a little bit delicate, I'm adding silver flowers. This is our finished house dress. She's a little bit flirty, a little bit sexy, and definitely reads as a Slytherin. What do you guys think? We are back with our Hogwarts house dresses, and we are doing our kings and queens of inclusion, the Hufflepuffs. Now, I wanted to make something ministry approved, so we are doing a tailored jumpsuit for this look. I'll start by using my serger and then move to the sewing machine, but not without our corgi break. For the top of the jumpsuit, I really wanted something bold and attention-grabbing, so we did a draped one-sleeve look with black binding. I then added a black metal belt, and here you are, the final look, ready for the ministry. We are on house three of our Hogwarts house dresses, and we are doing the kings, queens, and royalty of the Gryffindor house. Now, this entire dress is made out of a carpet fabric I found that kind of looks like the one from the common room, and once I saw it, I definitely felt like I had to use it. Time for a corgi break. I kept the front of the dress simple with fan-shaped boning channels because I wanted this elegant fabric to speak for itself. I paired her with a straight skirt that I serged the edges, and then I added a gold chain, and this is our final Gryffindor look,